Somewhere in our darkest history, the body of a sleeping king lies low. Under the earth, under anonymous trees of the border forests, where is he now? From the grave below the unmarked stones, 600 years of myth grow from his bones. Time does not quell the memories. Am I amongst friends? Can you still speak a few words of Cymraeg? I'm glad. I shall dare therefore to wear once more the colours of Glyndŵr and talk to you of times gone, when cries of freedom echoed through our land and Owain was our leader. Let me introduce myself. My name is Robert ap Maredudd of Gesael Gyfarch Dol Benmain, not to be confused with my brother Ieuan. While he and his treacherous friend, Hulkin Llwyd of Glynllifon, held the castle in Carnarvon for the King of England, I was at the gate with my fellow men. Yes, one of the leaders of Glyndŵr's fight for freedom. Death would be my brother's prize, and dreams of glory mine, as I fought for a new dawn under Owain's rule. But alas, despite 8 years of raging war and victory for Glyndŵr in many battles, it was not to be. And years later, as my life draws to a close, Wales remains under the rule of a distant English king. Owain calling his men to arms now seems futile. Times have changed. The remnants of Glyndŵr's army are now scattered all over the mountains of Snowdonia, and their freedom a distant dream. But no one can take from me my memories of serving my glorious prince, from my days as a growing young man of 14 years old. Yes, such service was an honour and not a duty. Once a year, Owain called for our services on a foreign mission. This service would usually be for a period of just 6 weeks. We would then be free to return home to work the land, unless our homelands were under attack, of course. It would then be our duty to protect our lands and our loved ones for as long as it might take. Prince Owain would treat us, his leading knights, his Uchelwyr, as family. There could be as many as 150 of us at a time, so strong was his retinue. We would all be presented with a shield, a helmet, an axe and a crossbow, made from the wood of the strongest yew trees. We, the Cymru, are considered the world over as the champions of the bow and arrow. In many ways, it's our own invention and one of the deadliest tools of the battlefield. And if you didn't have a crossbow to hand, that trusted old battle axe would do the job. Bu hoch loigr, buiach liugoch. But for the last weary 5 years, I have had to look out for the foot soldiers of the English king. They wander our lands in an attempt to entrap any remnants of Owain's followers and transport us to the Tower of London, or an even more gruesome fate. For it is now 5 years, some would say, since Owain died in the arms of his daughter at Monnington in Herefordshire. According to others, perhaps not. There was never a grave laid in earth for the greatest of all Welshmen, and there is a good reason for that. Owain Glyndŵr is no ordinary man. He will not be devoured by the jaws of death. He will be snatched from them. While the Dragon of Wales breathes, Owain continues to accompany us. And while Owain is with us, I will keep his colours close, ready for the call-up when it comes. If Owain Glyndŵr is indeed in hiding somewhere within our lands, then it is your task, as his foot soldiers, to locate him. Have you an ancient building within your parish? An old farm, castle or church that dates back to the 1400s? An old cromlech or hill fort, maybe? Draw a map of such places close to you so that we can locate our leader before the English soldiers do so. And think of this. Have you seen your family tree? How far does it go back, I wonder? You may be related to Owain Glyndŵr. Your great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather may have been one of his uchelwyr, one of his knights like me. Enjoy your searching, and we shall meet up again on the uplands of Wales.